We're counting down to Christmas, and what better way to celebrate the holidays than by talking about Hallmark Christmas specials. We caught up with the host of Deck the Hallmark to do just that. Let's have a look. We're so excited to chat with you guys about Hallmark's countdown to Christmas, which I'm obsessed with, by the way.
Very true. So, Bran likes them. No, loves them. Panda loves. Likes them. Dan absolutely despises
Excuse
Hallmark
me?
Christmas movies.
Excuse
so,
me.
What can listeners expect from your podcast, Deck the Hallmark, which I think is a great name?
Oh, it's a lot of fighting. It's taking things way too seriously that weren't meant to be taken seriously. I genuinely love these movies. Dan genuinely hates them. And Pat's just kind of stuck here in the middle.
Yeah.
So we bicker a lot, but at the end of the day, we always hug, make some hot chocolate, and sing some songs. So it all turns out well here.
Dan, I got a bone to pick with you. I'm even wearing my holiday
please.
Shoes today.
Oh,
can you see?
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
Wow. Okay. I apologize.
A different program.
Like, wow, that was
a different podcast. Dan, why do you despise these Hallmark movies that I literally every Sunday like wind down my week with?
Because I typically enjoy actual movies.
Yeah.
Is typically the issue. I got to be honest. We've done like 400 of these now or something crazy like that. The first one I watched, I literally couldn't get through. Like after 20 minutes, I had to stop and take a break. And now like they go down pretty easily, but they're not, you know, I think what I've embraced is they're not trying to be good. You know what I mean? They're trying to be the thing that you wind down on Sunday with.
Yes.
They're not trying to be actual art. And so I enjoy how much I hate them. But they're not my thing. They're not my type of comfort food, but they are someone's. I just think anytime you make, you know, a movie in 15 days, you can't expect it to be good. You know what I mean? Like you can't expect it to be great. That's a high expectation. Like it's like popping in a DiGiorno's pizza and expecting it to be like gourmet, right? You're there to eat what you think is kind of your thought of what pizza is, not what it actually is.
You're not cooking your DiGiorno's right, Dan.
Delicious.
I don't know about that. I'll tell you one thing about these feel-good Hallmark movies. It's not only the plot, and I agree with you. You gotta understand what you're viewing. It's supposed to be really easy viewing. You can be on your phone at the same time, but I'll tell you what the kicker is. The kicker is the beautifully set towns, the music, the cardigans, the hats, the scarves. It immediately, just the ambiance and having it in the background sets a tone. It's almost like you have your Christmas tree up. It's the same type of thing. It's a decoration.
Ambiance.
It's feel good.
You were doing a full all that jazz. That you were here and here and uttered across.
Yes.
That was fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got all of it in there. Mm-hmm.
There were definitely spirit fingers involved. It put me on the Dan train, actually.
Welcome aboard.
It's like, is it that serious? Maybe it is. Okay. So, who do you think is the best Hallmark Christmas star of all time?
Okay.
Ooh. It's tough.
Well,
it's tough.
On the leading lady side of things, Nikki DeLoach, who's been doing this for years years.
That's Sam's
best. That's one of my best friends. She is.
She's a dear great. Friend of the show. She comes on all the time, and she is such a wonderful person.
Yeah.
And she's a legitimately good actress, and she crushes it every
best
time.
Of the best.
She really is good.
And then there's guys like Christopher Palaha, who's doing like other stuff. Like he's gonna be in the next Jurassic World. Like he's really great. Guys like Tyler Hines that looks good and acts. Gooder.
Which is a rarity on the Hallmark.
So there's a lot of good ones out there.
Thanks so much for chatting with us. You guys were a real treat. You can listen to Deck the Hallmark on any podcast player now. Thanks,
bye,
guys. Happy holidays.
Thank you.
Want more? You can get the trio's book out now called I'll Be Home for Christmas Movies, your guide to your holiday TV obsession. Available at deckthehallmark.com.